go, Mark. All right, hello everybody. Thank you for coming out to the 2300 Arena. This is the press conference for the Friday night fight, September 29th, which will be here live on 11 Sports Network. And so I'm excited about the fight. It's going to be a great card from top to bottom. It's something that we've been accustomed to doing lately here in Philadelphia. And everybody knows Philadelphia is probably the best fight town in the world. So I love doing it. I have some great fights on the card featuring, I'm going to start from the opening TV bout. As a matter of fact, I'll talk about some of the undercard fights first of all. We have a young kid that I just recently signed that this would be news, Brandon Robinson, who's fought on a couple of my cards. Brandon Robinson, 6-1 with 5 knockouts. Very excited fighter. And I'm really excited about what the future holds for Brandon Robinson. He should be here shortly, but I had to get released at news. We also got Eric Spring, who's fought on my cards a couple times from Reading, Pennsylvania. He's in a tough fight with Anthony Prescott, who always comes to fight. Doesn't always get the right decisions, but the kid's always in the fight no matter who he's fighting. We have a good fight with a local kid as well from Philadelphia named Maynard Allison, who's fighting Juan Rodriguez. That ought to be an exciting fight. I don't think Maynard's ever fought in Philadelphia before. This would be his first time fighting in Philadelphia, to my knowledge. Maynard's 9-1, and that should be an exciting fight. That'll be the first fight of the night. So make sure you get out, get there early so you don't miss that fight. Juan Rodriguez is a tough competitor, and he comes to fight as well. We have a total of 10 fights on the card. And that's even after losing our original main event between Cecile and Gabe Fan. So, as always, Kings Promotions works hard to bring you the best fights possible. And there's a number of other undercard fights. A kid named Rasheed Johnson, who will have 100 people in the audience cheering for him as he goes up against Demetrius Williams, who will also probably have 30 or 40 people audience as well. So it's always great when you have that Philly competition. And I've learned from one of the best around, Russell Melton, who's known for doing that. And I have no problem taking my hat off to Russell because he's a Hall of Famer without a doubt. So I'm excited about the card on Friday night. We're going to bring you a lot of action. You'll get every dollar's worth. Another thing I wanted to announce that we will donating $1 from every ticket that's sold to Puerto Rico to help out what's going on over there with the many troubles that they're having from the flood and from the hurricane and everything else that's happened in the last couple of weeks there, the last 2 weeks or so. So we're doing that. And then as we do our 50-50 raffle, half of those proceeds will also go to Puerto Rico. So we feel that it's our duty to give back. And I think it's the only right thing to do, as those people need help. And anything we can do to continue to help out our brothers in Puerto Rico, our sisters in Puerto Rico, I think it's the only right thing to do. So I'm very excited about the card. This would be our third event that we're doing with 11 Sports Network. 11 Sports Network is their new network that's coming together and they cover college football, NFL football, college basketball, NBA basketball, boxing, soccer, you name it. They're a sports entertainment network. So I'm excited to be part of them, and I'm looking forward to some of the events that we'll be bringing, not only in Philadelphia, but throughout the United States. Now let me get to the opening bout on TV. I've been trying to make this fight happen for quite some time. I put the man to the left of me, Jerome Conquest. I put Jerome on a couple of my cards. And I remember a little over a year ago, Nick Lazario saying to me that he wanted Carlos to fight Jerome. So I'm like, oh, really? I said, okay. I said, you know, gotta be careful what you ask for. So So I said, but that's what you want? Let me see if I can make it happen. Timing just wasn't right. So I put Jerome got hurt. I was patient, I put Jerome on a card, I put Jerome on another card. And I like Jerome. How can you not like Jerome? He's a great individual, he's a great person, and he comes to fight. And that's all he wants to do, he wants to fight. He wants to be the best he can possibly be. He has a great team around him, with Wade and his brother. They're great trainers, they're consistent, and they continue to produce good fighters over and over again. So I'm excited to have Jerome on my card. I'm even more excited to finally make this fight happen between Jerome and Carlos. Carlos just came off of a loss, tough loss against Josh Davis. And so I think the fight is right for both of them. I think the fight is even better for Jerome at this point. You know, I'm sure Carlos has a few questions in the back of his mind. But it's a fight that's been stirring up for the last year or so. So I'm very excited about it. It's also going to be for a junior title with the WBF. James Gibbs has brought that together for us, and I made it happen. So the winner of Friday night's fight will go home with a junior belt to take home and put on their mantle or sleep with it or whatever they want to do with it. You know, and so I'm excited about it. And, you know, we don't have Carlos here with us, but we do have Jerome with us. So it's my pleasure to introduce Jerome Conquest. Carlos isn't here, and I'm really looking forward to a great fight tomorrow night. I think Darrell even mentioned that he thinks this fight is really labeled as the main event. And then because when you have this rival, it makes for a great fight. It just makes for a very good, entertaining fight. From a crowd perspective, they're going to be cheering. You know, you're going to have Carlos' fans, you're going to have Jerome's fans, and it's going to just be a great night of fights. And I'm really looking forward to it. And honestly, even though Carlos is supported by me, I almost feel like Jerome's been promoted by me as well, because I think this is our fourth or fifth fight that I'm putting him in. So, like I said, I've done that because I really like him. He's one of those individuals that you know he's humble, and he always comes and he'll give his best no matter what. So, I'm excited about that. Leading on to the co-feature of the night, originally this was going to be the opening bout, but due to the Castillo fight being canceled, this young man, I think we might have had six or seven fights together, and he's from the Baltimore area, and he, when I talk about someone being humbled and never asking for much except for just, hey, when can I fight again, you know? When I was introduced to him by a good friend of mine, Ross Polovinsky, he said he's 6'3", 6'4", 140 pounds. I was like, get out of here. He said, yeah, I think he probably can make 35. What is he, all bone? I mean, what the heck? You know, so I was a little leery about, like, can this kid really fight or what, you know? And the first fight I put him in with, I think I put him in with a kid from, where was the kid from? From Hungary. Who was like 16 and 4 or something like that. And he looked spectacular. He dropped the kid and just looked very good. And the next fight, he fought a kid in D.C., I believe it was. This kid ended up going on to dropping a kid who just fought here not too long ago, Julian Rodriguez. And he dropped him in the fight, you know? And the mark on Mike is that he's not a big puncher, but Mike can punch. He just doesn't, you just don't get to see it all displayed. Where he just lets it all hang out. I believe tomorrow, Friday night, when he's under the lights and he's in with probably his toughest test yet, I think we're going to see that. On top of that, he's moving up the weight a little bit. Instead of fighting at 140, he's now fighting at 144, 143 to 144. And so I think we're going to start to see his power in some of these fights as he continues to develop in his weight as well. And this young man has impressed me over and over again in his fights with just his boxing ability, with his chin. I put him to the test two fights ago against Trayshawn Wiggins, who was really a puncher two fights ago, right? Yeah. I put him in a fight with Trayshawn Wiggins two fights ago, who was a puncher. He was a southpaw, he could really punch. Mike took his best shots and looked very impressive in the fight. So I'm excited about this young man. I'm excited about what the future holds for him. I think we're going to see a future world champion at 147, even 154, and possibly even 160. Guys who haven't seen him, because he's been fighting down in the Baltimore, D.C. area, he's even fought for him once in Bethlehem, you're going to see a young man who's 6'3", 6'4", who has the ability to box and not run. He stays in the pocket a lot. He's not one of those type of guys who runs, he's right there in front of you, but he doesn't allow you to hit him. So his defense is very good, and his offense is even better. He's fighting a tough kid from Ecuador named Marlon Aguas, who his only loss is to a very tough competitor in Ivan Pulo, Glob at 147. So, he'll be in town tomorrow morning, and it was my pleasure to introduce Michael Fox to the Bible.
So, first off, I want to thank Marshall Pope. This is my second fight out of my second fight away from home. I got to thank Julian Castillo because I have to co main event since then, my favorite is no longer the card. I got to thank my team. My coach and father, Troy Fox, is right here in the front. The rest of my team is on the way. If you ask anybody about me, because most of y'all probably don't know me, if you ask anyone about me, I've never shied away from competition. So people always ask me, like, so when are you going to get on TV? When is this? When is that? I'm like, as long as I stay fighting, I'm not worried about it. I never want to be out of the ring for too long chasing the TV. I'm fighting tough opponents. I don't know if this is going to be the toughest fight. You'll have to ask me after the fight. And he's 9-1, so on paper, this is the best opponent I have. But that excites me. I'm not one of those take it easy fight type of guy. I want to see what my skills are. That's for me. And in the long run, I hope y'all can do that. So once again, thank you, Marshall. Thank you, my team, for getting me properly prepared. And I see y'all Friday night.
How tall?
How tall is he?
I want to say he's 5'10".
Everybody you fight must be smaller than you.
Yeah, they are.
They're the same style, they're coming in, they're trying to get inside on you.
Yeah, typically they don't have a choice. Everybody brings something different to the table. One thing I do know, they have to get in close to fight.
Your brother's fighting for a title, isn't he?
It's not for a title. No, it's not for a title. He's fighting on HBO. He's fighting with Demetrius Andre.
He's late, but he's here. Mr. Brandon Robinson.
He wrote.
I think he did that on purpose to try to steal the show. The main event, unfortunately, always has to wait till last. So,
you want to let Brandon say a couple words?
So before we move on to the main event, once again, I'd like to introduce Brandon Robinson. Newly signed Kings Promotions fighter.
Hi, I'm Brandon Robinson, and I want to thank God for bringing me here today. I want to thank God for helping me get to the camp. See, I want to thank Marshall Kaufman for putting me on the card. It's an honor to fight in British Chicago. I'd just like to show everything that I got in this fight. I worked real hard. I'm Charlotte from no hard work. I don't cut no corners, none of my road work, none of my strength conditioning, I don't cut no corners. I'm pretty much gonna brand myself as an old school fighter, like a Terry Norris, a Marvelous, Marvin Harry, Julian Jackson. So that's how I'm gonna kind of brand myself. And I'm looking to show what I can do tomorrow on a Friday night. Thank you.
September 20th, we had a meeting. My room, September 18th, right before I had to show up in Bethlehem. We came to an agreement on the contract, and September 20th, I started looking for somebody. So 9 days ago is when Brandon was added to the card. So I'm happy that he's on the card, and look forward to him not only fighting in VA, which he has a great following in Pennsylvania, as everybody knows. Been fighting all over Houston, Florida, you name it. Speaking of Florida, this gentleman to the left of me, and I'm going to talk about the trainer, the manager, Gil. I've known Gil for a number of years now. I've called Gil for a couple different guys that he's worked with over the years. And Gil's been boxing for a long time, and I remember the very first dealing I had with Gil. He got me a guy from Arizona to fight Frank Diallo. And it was a card I did in Redding. And I forget the name, but in boxing, as everybody knows, there's booking fees. So I owed Gil a booking fee. But I took a bad hit financially on that card. And I called Gil, I was like, look, man, I ain't got the money right now. I said, bear with me, I'll get you the money. And this man was patient, and I remember, weeks might have gone by, it might have even been a month. And I finally sent him the money, and he was like, man, thank you. He said, you're about one of the only guys that kept your word and said you were going to do something and did it. And so since then, we became closer, we became friends. And when I went through my heart procedure, he reached out to me daily. He was asking me, hey, how do you feel? And so my hat's off to this man. And when I have a card, I send out a voucher sheet to different matchmakers, booking agents, trainers, and so on. And he'll reach out to me and say, hey, I have a guy named Alonzo Melendez. who, you know, he's interested in a fight, another fight, Antonio Russell. And I was like, okay, this is our offer. I gave Antonio Russell's people his name, and they're like, no, we don't want that fight. I was like, so I called Gil back, and I'm like, no, that's not gonna happen. So as I worked out the deal with Christian's team and his father to put Christian on the card, I said to him, what about Christian Carlos? He said, yeah, we'll take that fight as well. So working with Gil has been a pleasure. You know, Gil says he's going to deliver, he brings a guy, and I said to him, when I looked at the guy, I said, man, Gil, this is a tough kid, man. He's 14-1 with 11 knockouts. I said, this is a tough kid. I don't know, 12 knockouts, forgive me. So I said, this is a tough kid, man. I don't know if we're ready to take this step yet with Christian. I said, let me talk to his team and let's see what's going on and let's see if we can make it happen. And sure enough, he made it happen. Gil's here today. He brought him, he delivered him. Medicals are done, he's ready to go. And so I'm excited about that. So I'm going to introduce Gil. Gil will speak for a while. Gil, how you guys doing?
Good to say about him.
Nothing good.
You know, I got everything good to say about him. Like you were saying about the money issue. We all need money, but I didn't push him, I didn't rush him, and sure enough, today I nailed it, the check, besides the point. He's always offering me work, always reminding me of this guy, this guy. And he offered me that card with Russell. I have this kid here, Ocho Melendez. We had already spoke a little bit about Christian Cardinals with William Reese. He had spoke a little bit about it and he had said, no, not yet, no, but it should be a TV fight, this and that. So then, my boy's been here with me for maybe 5 months, 6 months, and we've been training hard. He's ready as underdog. You know, we're not signed to nobody. I manage him, I train him. We got no promoter behind us, hopefully after Friday night. We'll open some eyes. And my boy's ready, I respect the other kid, Christian Cardinal, I respect his team, and may the best kid win Friday night. He's going to do what he has to do. I've had the pleasure of watching him fight.
Matter of fact, when they did the award in Philadelphia a couple years ago, he got, I think, outstanding boxer as an amateur at that time. And I got outstanding promoter of the year. Remember that? It was like a couple years ago, the Dave something awards. And so, matter of fact, it was just 2 years ago. Forget that this man's only been pro for a year. And so, it's just exciting to see his growth, to see him grow as a young man, to see him grow as a boxer. And I can see why he is the type of young man he is, because when you talk to his father, when you talk to his brothers, when you talk to people in his family, you see where it comes from. You know, they're all great individuals, they're all very respectful, and they all care about other individuals. And so that makes me excited to work with him. I'm looking forward to Friday night's fight. When I presented the 14-1 kid to him, they looked at him and they said, yeah, let's make it happen, you know? And this will be his first 8-rounder as well. And so it's my pleasure and honor to introduce the young man that I truly believe is going to be the future of boxing, as Lomachenko is today, someday, in a much smaller weight class, because I think he has all the ability in the world to make it happen. Christian Carlin.
Yeah, well, a couple photos I want, we'll take. First, we'll do Christian and Alonzo, and then you with, so Christian and Alonzo, we'll do one with you guys. Hold on 1 second.
Just
guys.
I get this.